أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله عز وجل وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وبعد Indeed, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, we beseech Him, we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evilness of our souls and the evilness of our actions. Whoever Allah Ta'ala has guided, there's no one to mislead. Whomever He has led astray, there's no guide for them. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and doesn't have any partners. As I bear witness that Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Muhammad the son of Abdullah, is His servant. Of Allah is the servant of Allah or the slave of Allah who is not worshipped and he is his final messenger who would blindly follow and obey sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As for what follows from the most truthful of all speech is the book of Allah and the finest of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evilest of affairs are novelties in the religion, for all novelties in the religion will lead to innovation, every innovation will lead to misguidance. And Allah and His Messenger has established that the ending place for all misguidance is the hellfire. May Allah protect us from the hellfire. Ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, after A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytani ar-rajim, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Allah says today, Surah Al-Ma'idah. He said today, and this day that Allah said this was Yom Jum'ah. It was on a Friday like this day, but on the day of Arafah. The day of Arafah in the month of Dhul Hijjah, the 12th month on the Islamic calendar. This was the final revelation given to the Messenger of Allah from the Qur'an as commandments and prohibitions. Allah Ta'ala says, today I have completed for you your way of life, your religion, your means of earning rewards and punishment. I have completed for you this day your way of life and I have perfected upon you my bounty. I have perfected upon you my bounty. And I am pleased for you as your way of, as I am pleased with you and Islam as your way of life, for your means to earn rewards and punishments. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, Ibn Kathir, let's hear what he has to say about this ayah. Ibn Kathir says, after quoting this ayah in his tafsir, أَكْبَرُ نِعْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَى هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ, that the greatest bounty that Allah has placed upon this nation, حَيْثُ أَكْمَلَ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمْ, is the religion of Islam, in which He has completed and perfected for them their religion, their way of life. فَلَا يَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَى دِينٍ غَيْرٍ, they are not in need of any other way of life other than it. وَلَا نَبِيَّ غَيْرَ نَبِيِّهِمْ, and there is no prophet for them after other than their prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَلِهَذَا, so for this reason, هُوَ خَاتِمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, he is the seal of prophets and messengers. وَبُعِثَ إِلَى الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ, and he has been sent to jinn kind and mankind. فَلَا حَلَالُ إِلَّا مَا أَحَلَّهُ, there is nothing that is deemed as permissible except what he has defined as permissible. وَلَا حَرَامَ إِلَّا مَا حَرَّمَ, and it's not something deemed as prohibited except that he already has defined it as prohibited. وَلَا دِينَ إِلَّا مَا شَرَعَ, and there is no religion other than what he has legislated. وَكُلُّ أَخْبَارِهِ حَقٌ وَصِدْقٌ لَا كَذَفِي وَلَا خُلْفِ, and every single thing that he has informed about is the truth. It is reality. There is no lying in it, nor is there any deception in it whatsoever. And then Ibn Kathir quoted the ayah, تَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدَقًا وَعَدَلًا, and the perfect words of your Lord have become perfected in truthfulness and in justice. Surah Al-An'am. And he says, صِدَقًا, it has become, the perfect words of Allah has become completed and perfected. Fil akhbar is truthful in what it has informed of. Wa adala fil awamir wa nahari, and it is just in its commandments and its prohibition. Falamma akmala alayhim ad-deen, so when Allah completed upon this religion, as he said in the ayah, tammat alayhim an-ni'mah, then his greatest bounty become completed for them. And today, al-yawm, today, akmaltu lakum, I have completed for you deenakum, your religion. Wa atmamtu alaykum, and I have perfected upon you ni'mati, my bounty. Wa raditu lakum al-islam madina, and I made Islam for you, I am pleased for you and Islam as your way of life. The Kathir goes on. He says, meaning, when Allah says this, what this supposed to mean to us? I فَرْضُوهُ, find contentment in it. أَنْتُمْ لِأَنْفُسِكُمْ, you, for your own sake, for your own selves. فَإِنَّهُ الدِّينَ الَّذِي أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَضِيَهُ, for it is the religion in which He is pleased and loves it, and is pleased with it. وَبَعَثَ بِهِ أَفْضَلُ الرُّسُلُ الْكِرَامُ, and He sent with this religion the best of the noble messengers. وَأَنْزَلَ بِهِ أَشْرَفِ الْكُتُبَ, and he, أَشْرَفُ الْكُتُبِ, and he's descended or revealed with that prophet the most noblest of books. And this is what Ibn Kathir says about this ayah. Ibn Abbas said about this ayah, who in Islam, this ayah is the whole religion of Islam. أَخْبَرَ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا, that Allah has informed His prophet, وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ صلى الله عليه وسلم, and He has informed the believers, أَنَّهُ أَكْمَلَ لَهُمُ الْإِيمَانِ, that He's completed their faith, their belief system. فَلَا يَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَى زِيَادَةٍ أَبَدًا, they are in no need of any additions at all. وَقَدْ أَتَمَّهُ اللَّهُ فَلَا يَنْقُصُهُ أَبَدًا, and Allah, Ibn Abbas, the companion of the Prophet, goes on to say, and indeed Allah has perfected it for them. And for therefore there's no decreasing whatsoever in it ever, abadan. وَقَدْ رَضِيَهُ, and He is pleased with this way of life. فَلَا يَسْخَطُهُ أَبَدًا, and He will never be angry or displeased with it ever. Again, وَقَدْ أَتَمَّهُ اللَّهُ, Allah has perfected it, the religion. فلا ينقصه أبدا. He will never decrease it whatsoever. وقد رضي. Decrease it meaning it will stay preserved. It will stay preserved. He will never decrease the perfection of this religion. And he went on, وقد رضي. And he's pleased with it. فلا يسخطه أبدا. And he'll never be displeased with this way of life. For this shows us when Allah revealed this ayah, the religion is done. Only thing left is tafahum, is understanding it. وَعَمِلُوا بِهِ and implementing in your life. لَا يَحْتَاجِ لَسْيَابِ don't need nothing to add to it that can get you closer to Allah. This is what he's clarifying. And there is no need to remove anything from it. Allah perfected it for us. The student of Ibn Abbas, the Sudi said, نزلت هذه الآية يوم عرفة. That this ayah was revealed on the day of عرفة. فلم ينزل بعدها حلال ولا حرام. It never came down after this ayah any legislation for what's halal and what's haram. ورجع رسول الله. And the Messenger of Allah returned back to Medina after that Hajj fanat and he died. And one of the narrations said that the Messenger of Allah lived 81 days after that ayah was revealed. So Allah perfected this religion. As Asma bint Umais, the female companion of the Prophet, she said, on that Hajj, she said, Hajjtu ma'a Rasulillah. I made pilgrimage with the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tilka al-hajja. That final farewell Hajj. Fabainana nahnu nasiru. She said, and while we were traveling with the Prophet, ittajalla lahu Jibreel. Suddenly appeared before him Jibreel. فَمَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الرَّاحِلَةِ And the Messenger of Allah began to incline off of his riding beast. فَلَمْ تُتَقِرْ رَاحِلَةِ مِنْ ثِقْلِ مَا عَلَيْهَا مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ And the animal, the camel that the Messenger of Allah was riding on was not able to continue to stand because of the heavy burden that was on the camel when the revelation was coming down of the Quran upon him. It couldn't handle it for better effect. So it dropped to his knees, the camel. This is how heavy this legislation was when it was coming down. And this is the companion, Asma bint Umais, witnessing this reality. She watching revelation come upon the Prophet and the camel couldn't continue to move anymore. It dropped to his knees, an animal that could carry 30 times his weight, 100 times his weight. It couldn't take the burden of the revelation coming down upon the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she said it fell to his knees. It fell to his knees. It couldn't carry the burden. For ataytuhu, and the Messenger of Allah was sweating profusely. So I came to him. فَسَجَّيْتُ عَلَيْهِ بُرْدَى كَانَ عَلَيَّ And so I covered him up with a garment that I was wearing because he was shivering. In a hot day, he was shivering, started to sweat. So she covered him up, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this is how this deen came down. It's not an easy religion, brother. An easy religion that's the meaningless, not a religion that's supposed to be taken lightly by us. But it's a way of life that's supposed to be learned, understood, and practiced. Not innovated or added to it. Thinking it's good to do something. Because what's been good, فَقَدْ سَبَقُونَا إِلَى ذَلِكَ What has been established as good is always, they have preceded us in that good. And from amongst those things that is good, is what's been legislated. And if we think we can bring another addition that's going to be a good deed, that Allah has not been preceded by Allah and his messenger and his companions, then know for certain, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you are deceived. For Imam Malik, Rahimahullah, he said, مَنِ اتَّدَعَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ بِدْعَةً That whoever innovates in the religion of Islam, any form of innovation, meaning something that the Prophet didn't do and the companions didn't do, whoever innovates in Islam, that which, in the innovation, يَرَاهَ حَسَنًا And he deems that thing he has innovated as a good deed, فَقَدْ زَعَمَ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا خَانَ الرِّسَالَةً Then they have made a claim. They have truly made a claim that Muhammad was treacherous in conveying his message to us. That person who newly introduced things into the religion that the prophet did not bring and say, this is a good deed, this is a good practice, this is a good thing to do. Imam Malik says that that person is claiming that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was treacherous in conveying this message to us. Why Imam Malik is saying that? He says, لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى يَقُولُ. He says, because Allah says, أَلْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ. I have completed for you your religion. So if you say something that's being done after him is good for this ummah, then you're saying the prophet was treacherous because Allah says he completed this way of life for us. That's why Ibn Kathir said what he said, and Ibn Abbas said what he said, and Imam Masudi said what he said. And then Imam Malik went to end his statement was saying, فَمَا لَمْ يَكُمْ يَوْمَا إِذٍ دِينًا. For what was not religion during that time, meaning the time of the life of the Messenger of Allah, فَلَا يَكُونَ يَوْمَ دِينًا. There's no way possible today it can be considered as religion. This Imam Malik, Imam al-Dar al-Hijra, he said this statement. Also, our beloved Tabi'i al-Fubayl ibn Iyad, he said about the ayah, لِيَبَلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, that Allah will test you to see which you are most excellent in their deed. He said, أَخْلَصَهُ وَأَصْوَبَهُ. When Allah says who's most excellent in their deeds, he said Allah means the most sincerest of it and the most correct of it. فَقِيل, it was said to him, مَا أَخْلَصَهُ وَأَصْوَبَهُ. What is the most sincere of deeds? What is the most correct of deeds? Imam Fudayl ibn Iyad, he said, إِنَّ الْعَمَلَ, for verily the deeds that is done, إِذَا كَانَ خَالِصًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ صَوَابًا لَمْ يُقْبَلْ. He said that if the deeds that are done or actions that are done, when they are sincerely for Allah, then, and it's not correct, meaning according to, and it's not correct, it is not accepted. وَإِذَا كَانَ صَوَابًا, and when that deed that is done is correct, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ خَالِصًا, and it's not sincere, that yuqbal, it will not be accepted. حَتَّى يَكُونَ, until that deed becomes خَالِصًا وَصَوَابًا, until it becomes sincere and correct. And he defined what's sincere and correct. He says, الْخَالِصْ أَنْ يَكُونَ لِلَّهِ. He says, sincere is that it be for Allah alone. وَصَوَاب, and it being correct, the deed, أَنْ يَكُونَ عَلَى السُنَّةِ, is that it be in agreement with the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which requires knowledge, which requires education. This is why Imam Bukhari chapters in his Sahih Bukhari, Bab chapter, Al-Ilm Qabl al-Qawli wal-Amal. Chapter, it's the chapter of Sahih Bukhari. Chapter, knowledge precedes statements and actions. Knowledge precedes statements and actions. That's why Allah Ta'ala tells us, brothers and sisters, Ya ayyuha al-ladina amanu, Surah Al-Hujurat, O you who believe, La tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa Rasul. Do not proceed before Allah and His Messenger. Don't proceed to think something's good or do any actions or belief or any of that unless, really, before Allah and His Messenger. Wattaqu Allah. Allah says, and fear Allah. Inna Allah sami'un alim. Allah is the all-hearing and the all-aware. In other words, He's going to take you to account for that. So brothers and sisters in Islam, when Imam Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad made this statement, he said, and then he quoted the ayah as evidence, that فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ, that whoever hopes to meet with his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, then let him do righteous deeds, meaning according to the Sunnah. Let him do righteous deeds. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ فِي عِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحْدًا, and let him not associate in the worship of his Lord anything or anyone. And that's sincerity, brothers and sisters in Islam. So the deen of Islam has been established. It has been clarified. And it's upon us to learn it and understand it. هَذَا وَصَلَّ اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمُ وَبَارِكَ عَلَى نَبِيَنَا مُحَمَّدًا وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ. بسم الله والحمد لله حمدا كثيرا وطيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب الله تبارك وتعالى ويرضاه وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. The scholars of Islam has established what is the sunnah of the Prophet, what defines what is the sunnah of the Prophet. And that is, they say, ما أضيف إلى النبي, that which has been connected to the Prophet, من قول of statements, or فعل or actions, or وصف or descriptions and attributes. وتقرير, number four, is what he agreed upon. So in other words, whatever the Prophet said, whatever he did, whatever the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was described with, and whatever he approved of, an approval of the Prophet, هو أعمال أصحابي, that was the actions of his companions, that he saw them doing and he approved of it, and says this was okay. This is what defined the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Understand that. And so therefore we understand that this is where we find what Sunnah. And the Sunnah of itself is categorized into five categories. The first category is Sunnatul I'tiqadiyah, the what the Prophet established as our belief system, what we're supposed to believe in. Yani, we believe in that which the Messenger of Allah believed in. And his Sunnah is also Sunnatul Qawliyah, that which is established from his Sunnah, from his statements. In other words, we say what he said. We say what the Messenger of Allah said. And also Sunnatul Fi'liyah, the sunnahs are from his actions. Meaning we do what we know saw the Messenger of Allah doing. Like he said, for example, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli, pray as you have seen me praying. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the third category. The fourth category of the sunnah is sunnatul taqririyah, those sunnahs that he has established, meaning what the Prophet has established to be done from the actions of his companions is been approved of, then we approve of that as well, sunnah. And last but not least, sunnatul tarkiyah, sunnahs that is from his sunnah to leave off whatever the Prophet left off. Meaning what the Prophet left and didn't do, we avoid from doing it. What the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do, then we avoid from doing it. But this is an important aspect of the deen of Islam. So understanding that reality, tomorrow, brothers and sisters in Islam, is going to be the 12th, inshallah, of the month of Rabi' al-Awwal, that is claimed to be the birthday of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And many Muslims, unfortunately, celebrate the birthday of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this practice is something that the Messenger of Allah never did during his lifetime. Not for his own birthday. This is an action that the companions never did during their lifetime. Nor did we see the Atba'u Tabi'een, the followers of the companions. They never practiced this, nor the followers of the followers. Those first three generations, no two scholars differ. No one ever celebrated the birthday of the Prophet. We're coming together and enjoying one another and having fun and celebrating and saying praises of the Messenger of Allah. None of this ever existed. And people say, I do this out of mahabbah, out of love for the Messenger of Allah, out of magnifying the Messenger of Allah. So we say to that, who can love the Messenger of Allah better than Abu Bakr? Who can love the Messenger of Allah better than Aisha? Better than Umar or Uthman or Ali or any of the companions? How come they didn't precede us in this act? Brother, people put on the Islamic calendars the 12th day of Rabi' al-Awwal, which is tomorrow, they say that this is Eid al-Mawlid al-Nabi Nabawi. This is the Eid of the Prophet's birthday. A'udhu Billah. The Messenger of Allah said when he entered Medina, there was 2 days, كانوا يلعبون, that they used to play in them. He said, فَقَدْ أَبْدَلَكُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُمَا, that Allah has exchanged those days y'all enjoy yourselves with 2 other days. And he said, Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. Why did the Messenger of Allah say that? Because when you take a date and specify that date to repeat itself, it becomes worship. So the Messenger of Allah said,
these, when he entered Medina, لما قدم إلى مدينة, when he entered Medina, he saw the people celebrating and enjoying themselves. He said they're playing. They set these day, 2 days to play in. Just to play. But because it's a repetitive time at every year, he said, فَقَدْ أَبْدَلَكُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُمْ and that Allah has exchanged those days with two other days, Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. The two Eids that we have. But the word Eid, brothers, it means repeat itself. From the word Auda, it means to repeat. It's an answer. It becomes worship. And Allah already said as we began, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. I have completed for you your religion. That's one point. Thirdly, if we claim and we love the messenger, love Allah, or love the messenger of Allah, Allah addressed that issue too. He addressed that issue too. If you're doing this celebration because your love for the messenger of Allah, most of us doing it because our culture, not because it's legislated in the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger. But we say if we do this out of love for the messenger of Allah. Allah addressed those people who claim they love Muhammad. What did Allah say to them? He says, قُلْ say, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ if you love Allah, فَاتَّبِعُونِي follow me, meaning Muhammad. Follow me, يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ and Allah will love you. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ and Allah is often forgiving, most merciful. So if you really claim to love Muhammad, follow him. And this is from his sunnatun tawqiyah. This is from the things that he abandoned. We leave what he left. He didn't celebrate his birthday. We should not celebrate his birthday. Also, the day that we choose for the birthday of the Prophet, the 12th, there's no authentic narrations to confirm what day was the Prophet born in. Some scholars they differ so much. Some scholars say the 2nd of the Rabi' al-Awwal. Others said the 8th of Rabi' al-Awwal. Others said the 9th of Rabi' al-Awwal. Others said the end of Rabi' al-Awwal. Some said the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. But because we have no text to confirm it, the scholars differ. And it's a wisdom why Allah kept that from us. And this practice didn't exist with the Ummah of Muhammad till the 4th century by extreme Shia. The Ubaidiyya and the Falkaniyin, the people who were kufar, who the scholars during that time looked at as non-Muslims because they rejected the messengership of Muhammad. And they looked at their leaders as gods with Allah. They started this practice. But because Ahlul Sunnah did not follow them, it didn't affect them. Then in the Hijra calendar of the year 1613, a ruler that was Muslim on the Sunnah of Ahlul Sunnah, he started the celebrating of the Prophet, and that's when it took off. And it's been continuing since 600 years after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the scholars from then till now, from the 7th generation, to the 8th, to the 9th, to the day, have warned the Ummah from this act. Because Allah has completed this way of life for us. Secondly, if you want to celebrate the Prophet's birthday, celebrate it the way he celebrated it. How did he celebrate his birthday? When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the companions saw him fasting on Yawm al-Khamis wa Yawm al-Ithnain, on Thursdays and Mondays, su'il, he was asked, why do you fast on his days? He said, Yawm al-Ithnain, Yawm al-Walidtu, Yawm al-Ithnain was the day, Monday was the day I was born. And he also said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we also know that was the day that he died, was a Monday. On his birthday. And how did he celebrate it? He fasted. So if you really love Muhammad, do what he did. Fast on that day. Don't do the things that he never legislated. Allah completed this religion, not our cultures, not a group of people. Islam, brothers and sisters in Islam, is not democratic. It's not what the majority does. It's ما قال الله وقال الرسول وقال الصحابة ليس بالتمويل. That Islam is what Allah said, what his messenger said, and what the companion said, without any ambiguity in with that. Allah has completed this religion. He said he's pleased with what Muhammad, he gave Muhammad is for us. He completed his bounty. So if you practice something that the messenger of Allah did not bring, or did not practice, or nor his companions practice, like Imam Malik said, فَقَدْ زَعْمَ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدٍ خَانَ الرِّسَالَةِ that the messenger you were claiming, that the messenger of Allah was treacherous in conveying this message. Because obviously if Allah completed this religion, the messenger of Allah hid this from us. And you know that. And this is falsehood, brothers and sisters in Islam. So it's important for us. Yes, Islam ain't just a religion, they're talking about the beauty of it, but it's also defending this religion, clarifying the purity of it, and warning the Muslims from changing it and altering it and anybody else. So we should stay away from this practice. Likewise, if you in that next thing point is if you have an individual who had a child and he loved his child, and then after several years, his son or daughter dies on the same day that his son was born, will he be celebrating his son's birthday? Nobody looked like that, that's crazy, right? Well, the messenger of Allah was born on that day and he died on that day. Just like you wouldn't do it for your child, Rasulullah awla bi dhalik. The messenger of Allah has more right than that. For it is incumbent upon us, brothers and sisters in Islam, that we practice this religion the way it has been legislated, not the way our culture. So Islam is not your culture. Islam is not what you feel and what you want. But Islam is what's been legislated. That's why Allah commands us, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُمْ. Be upright and steadfast as you have been commanded. He didn't say, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا شِئْتُمْ. He didn't say, كَمَا شِئْتَمْ. Be upright and steadfast as you like, as you want. Define worship to what you feel we should be doing because I grew up in this type of... That's not Islam. For the Messenger of Allah said, Al-Islam bada al-ghariba. Islam begins as something strange. وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا كَمَا بَدَأَ. And it's going to return to being strange. To who? The Muslims. Like it began. Because many of us, especially Muslims from Muslim countries, we think Islam is what the people in my country did. You ask the average Muslims about many things that they do in their worship. They can't bring an ayah or a hadith, but they bring what my culture said or what mommy and daddy said. That's not Islam. Allah Ta'ala says, اتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Your Lord says, follow that which has been revealed to you from your Lord. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاهُ. And do not follow anything else less than that as trustworthy companions and trustworthy means. قَلِيلٌ مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Very little do you reflect. For that is Islam. And that requires knowledge. That requires learning. That requires reading. That requires sitting with the people who have learned this religion and conditioning them what producing evidence. Don't just follow him because he got a sheikh symbol next to his name or he got a PhD. Follow him with that which he present of evidence. And then question them. When they say Allah said, his prophet said, on whose understanding? Did the companions understand it that way? Well, that's your understanding, ya sheikh. And you put him in the ma'zik. That person's going to be tight now. He got to produce. But that's the deen of Islam. Because Allah says, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِنِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ. Those first foremost predecessors from the migrators and the helpers, meaning all the companions of the Prophet. This is what Allah says next in Surah At-Tawbah. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانِ. And those who followed them perfectly. Those who followed them perfectly. What Allah says? رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. What does that mean? You want Allah to be pleased with you? Follow the companions of the Prophet. Understand the Kitab, the Sunnah like the companions of the Prophet. For that is where success lies. Because I ask you a common sense aspect. If I was to present a person who had came to teach you something, whatever they teach you, who want to better understand that person's teaching? The one who he sat with and lived with and taught the religion to, or taught what he wanted to teach to them of his book, or the people who come many generations later? Who gonna understand it better? Common sense answer. Common sense answer. For these were the people who Allah chose for suhbati Muhammad, for the companionship of Muhammad. And Allah said all of them is in Jannah. وَكُلٌّ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah says in Surah Al-Hadid, and every one of them, we promised them paradise. So we want success, we want paradise, follow the religion on the understanding of the companions of the Prophet. For they are the ones whom Allah says, if we do that, we will have unity. We will come together. We will really love each other. But when we don't follow that and want to follow anybody who came after that, that's when the schisms and the separation occurs, like today. As Allah says, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا Surah Al-Baqarah, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا, and if they believe, بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ مَنْ قَالَ آمَنْتَ أَنْتَ يَا مُحَمَدْ قَالَ آمَنْتُمْ هُوَ وَمَنْ عَاشَ مَعَهُ كَمَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا, that if they believe as you, Muhammad, and your companions believe, they will be guided. وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, but if they turn away from your belief and your companions believe, فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ, then they are upon nothing but schism, separation, and splitting. فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ, and Allah will shall suffice you and them. So this is our success. We ask Allah to bless us not to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet. And whoever want to celebrate it, let them fast. Let them fast on Mondays to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet. Because that's when we know for certain he was born on Monday, because he said it. But he never told us what day of the in the month of Rabi' he was born. Let us not innovate. Oh Allah, protect us from innovating in this religion. Ameen. Oh Allah, make beloved to us learning the sunnah and practicing it. Oh Allah, make beloved to us learning the sunnah and practicing and spreading it to the Muslims. Oh Allah, make beloved to us hating that which is opposite of the sunnah and warn each other to stay away from it. So that you can aid us and establish this deen for this ummah like you did before. Wa aqim as-salah.
رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد كانت الصلاة وقد كانت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا تراصوا حد بين مناقب والأقدام فإن تسويت صف من تمام الصلاة straighten your rows, make your ranks close to one another and equalize between your shoulders and your ankles. When these straightening of the ranks is a part of establishing the prayer. أتم الصف الأول ثم الذي يليه حتى الصف الأخير حتى تقبل صلاتنا. Make sure the first rank is complete to the last rank so that our prayers can be accepted. Inshallah. Allahu Akbar.